Hi, my name is Tom. In this video, I'm going to help you set up your media players running Microsoft Windows 10 to power your digital signage displays with ScreenCloud. Using media players running Microsoft's Windows 10 operating system to power your digital signage displays have a lot of benefits. They come in various prices, sizes, specifications, and form factors. So if your budget allows, it's very likely you're gonna find one that suits your business needs. And as Windows 10 is a fully featured desktop operating system, you have a wide variety of apps that you can choose to run alongside ScreenCloud, including several remote device management options. Depending on the model you choose, you also have the option to power multiple screens from only one main device. Now, there are many devices in this category that we recommend. You can check them out on our hardware page at screen.cloud/hardware. Many of these devices come with Microsoft Windows 10 pre-installed. But if the one you choose doesn't, or if you have the need to reinstall Windows 10, we suggest you consult with the reseller you purchased your device from or refer to documentations on Microsoft's own website. Setting up ScreenCloud on Windows 10 powered media players is very easy. In this video, we're going to do it on the Intel NUC 8cc HKR. But the process should be very similar for any device you have. After you've completed the initial setup process, there are two key configurations we recommend you do if your Windows 10 powered media player is going to be used solely for digital media purpose. First, disable all notifications. You can do this by clicking on the Start menu at the bottom left corner of your main desktop. Select the Settings icon and select System. From the menu tab on the left-hand side of the screen, select Notifications and Actions, and turn off all notifications from apps and other senders. You can also uncheck all the remaining boxes. Please note, this will only work for core apps within the Windows operating systems. For custom apps, you will have to disable notifications from within the app itself. Second, make sure that your Windows 10 media player doesn't go to sleep during the operation hours. You can do this by selecting Power and Sleep from the menu tab and select Never for both the screen and sleep option. Now that you're ready to install the ScreenCloud Player app, please visit our download page at screen.cloud/download from your browser. Select the most suitable version listed under Windows or select the .exe version if you're not sure. When the download is finished, click on the downloaded file to start the installation process. When the app is opened for the first time, you will have the option to launch the ScreenCloud Player app every time the system starts up. If you're not sure what to do yet, don't worry. You can change this later in the settings menu. Now you'll see the custom pairing code. You can then use this to pair your Windows 10 media player by logging into your ScreenCloud account from the web browser on your computer. Select New Screen button on the top right corner of your screens tab. Input the pairing code and name your new screen. And that's it. You're now ready to set any content you'd like to show on your screen. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please be sure to check out our support page for more tips and tricks on how to make the best use of your ScreenCloud account.